In this illustration, we'll analyze a small block sliding on a wedge block. Here you can see in the figure, a triangular wedge block of mass 2m is placed on a smooth surface and it is of height h. And from its top, a small block of mass small m is released on the smooth inclined surface. We are required to find the speed attained by wedge block when this small block reaches the bottom of incline. Here in this situation, let's redraw the picture and analyze it when the block reaches the bottom. Here you can see this figure shows the situation when the small m block reaches the bottom. This wedge block will attain a speed say v1, and with respect to this block, say if m is gaining a velocity v2, then it will have two components of v2. If this angle is theta, this will be v2 cos theta, and in downward direction it is v2 sin theta. So with respect to ground, if we analyze, then the horizontal speed attained by the small m when reaches the bottom is v2 cos theta minus v1 because it is placed on 2m. And in downward direction it is v2 sin theta only, as the wedge block is not having any vertical velocity. So here we can write as no external horizontal force x on system, the total momentum in horizontal direction remain conserved. So in this situation we can write, when this small block reaches the bottom of this inclined wedge block, the leftward momentum attained by the block is 2mv1. This should be equals to the rightward momentum attained by the small block, which is m multiplied by v2 cos theta minus v1. And if we simplify this equation here, you can see we'll be getting the value of v2 is equals to 3v1 by cos theta. So this is our equation 1. And as no friction is present anywhere, so we can say whichever kinetic energy is gained by the system is due to work done by gravity. So we can write, by work energy theorem, we can write initial kinetic energy of system was 0 plus the work done by gravity on this block is mgh is equals to the final kinetic energy gained by the system. On this wedge block, kinetic energy is half multiplied by 2m into v1 square, plus the kinetic energy gained by this block of mass m is half m. This will be vx square plus vy square, so we'll write it like v2 cos theta minus v1 whole square plus v2 sin theta whole square. So this is the total kinetic energy of this small block. Here, if we substitute the value of v2 from equation 1 in equation 2, then here we can write from 1 and 2, if we put the values here, m can be cancelled in this equation, and rearranging the terms, we can write 2gh is equals to, this will be 2v1 square plus, here this v2 cos theta can be written as 3v1, so this will be 4v1 square plus, if we put v2 as 3v1 by cos theta, this will be 9v1 square 10 square theta. And further on solving, we'll get the value of v1, which is equals to root of 2gh divided by 6 plus 9 10 square theta. That is the result of this problem, the speed attained by the wedge block when a small block reaches the bottom of incline.